In this video, we take a look at video ad basics in the Ad Manager API. We go over the types of video ads, how to create ad units, line items, and creatives, and how to get reporting data on your video ads. Video content publishers can incorporate ads in a variety of ways. The first is a linear ad. These are what most people think of when they think of video ads. Linear ads are video ads that appear either before, after, or during the video content itself. This is the type of ad we will set up later in this video. Next, there are non-linear ads. Non-linear ads appear during the video content playback as an overlay on top of the video player without disrupting the video itself. Finally, you have companion ads, which are ads that display alongside a video player but do not show in the video player itself. Since this video deals with linear ads, let's take a closer look at that type of ad now. If this is your video content, there are a number of ways you can incorporate linear ads into it. Firstly, you have pre-roll ads. These are ads that play before the video content begins. Then you have mid-roll ads, which play at breakpoints in the video itself. You also have bumper ads, which are short, non-monetized ads that introduce the ad that's about to play. And finally, you have post-roll ads, which play after the video content. So now let's move on to actually creating video ad entities. First, we'll create a video ad unit, and then we'll create a video line item that targets the ad unit using inventory targeting. Then we'll make a VAST redirect creative, where VAST stands for Video Ad Serving Template, but more on that later. Finally, we'll use a line item creative association to connect the creative back to the video line item. First, we're going to create a video ad unit. But before jumping into the code, I want to highlight how we specify that this ad unit handles linear video ads. We do this in the Ad Unit Sizes field. Ad units have one of two types of sizes, standard sizes or video sizes. Standard sizes represent display ad slots, and video sizes represent ad slots in a video player. To specify a video size, set the environment type field to video player. Keep in mind that a single ad unit can combine standard sizes and video sizes, so you'll want to consider the best ad unit structure for your site. Moving over to a terminal, you can see I've prepared some examples already. We'll walk through each of them in this video. First, let's work on creating a video ad unit. We need a parent ad unit ID, so let's first get the top-level ad unit on my network. This example uses the network service to fetch the current network, and then it prints the root ad unit ID. Let's run this example now to get the ad unit ID. Let's copy that root ad unit ID and open the create video ad unit example. We can paste the ad unit ID in the parent ad unit ID field. In the main function, we get the inventory service, and then we define an ad unit size like we discussed earlier. Then we define an ad unit object with a name, the parent ID, a brief description, and our one video ad unit size. Finally, we call the createAdUnits API method to create this ad unit, and then we print the results. Let's run this example. As you can see, the ad unit has the size we defined. The returned ad unit object has a few notable fields that I'd like to mention before moving forward. First is the companions list. We didn't specify any companion ads, so this list is empty. But remember that companion ads show next to the video player, and this is how you specify the sizes for those companion ads. Second is the full display string field. In the UI, video ad sizes are designated with the letter V after the size, So this field represents how the ad unit will be displayed in the UI. Finally, there is an isAudio field that defaults to false. This field means that both audio and video ads are eligible on this ad unit. If you set isAudio to true, this ad unit will be restricted to only serve audio ads. You can find the link to our video on audio ads in the description box for this video. So now let's move on to creating a video line item. There are some additional required fields for video line items. The environment type must be set to video player. On the targeting object, let's set request platform targeting to video player as well. You can assign multiple values to request platform targeting to target the platform that requests and renders the ad. Possible values include video player, browser, and mobile app. Finally, there is video max duration, which is the maximum duration of a video creative associated with this line item in milliseconds. Video max duration has been required since version 2021.02 of the Ad Manager API. This field restricts the length of the creatives added to this line item. It's also useful information for our forecasting engine to generate accurate forecasts. There are also some optional fields for video line items. For example, you can set the skippable ad type field to enabled or disabled to determine whether viewers can skip your ad. Going back to the terminal, let's take a look at the create video line item example. We need to add this line item to an order. I already have an order ID to use here. We also need to add the ID of the video ad unit we just created. Then, in the main function, we first get the line item service, and then we define an end date of 1 year from now, and then we define the line item object. For the targeting object, we add our video ad unit ID to inventory targeting. Since this is a video line item, we also set the request platform targeting to video player, like this. Finally, we have the option of setting the video position targeting. For this example, we'll use pre-roll here. We also need to set the creative placeholders using a size consistent with what we added to our ad unit. Finally, be sure to set the environment type to video player. There are also some other required line item fields that we're setting here. Then we can call create line items and print the results. Let's run this example. As you can see, the environment type is set correctly. Also, inventory targeting looks good. And the video position targeting and the request platform targeting are correct as well. So now we move on to making a VAST redirect creative. VAST redirect creatives have a couple of required fields, such as the VAST XML URL. This is the URL where the third-party VAST XML is hosted. The tag we're using is a sample VAST ad from the IMA SDK developer documentation. For more information on the VAST XML URL query parameters, see the Help Center article linked in the video description. We're also setting the VAST redirect type to linear and the duration to 10 seconds or 10,000 milliseconds. Before we get to the code to create a VAST creative, we need to get a VAST URL. Let's head over to the IMA SDK developer documentation. Click on Resources and IMA Sample Tags. We'll copy the single inline linear tag for our example. Let's open up the code to make the VAST creative. We need to specify an advertiser ID from our network and the VAST XML URL we just got from the IMA SDK documentation. Notice that I added a cachebuster macro to the end of the URL. Ad Manager servers prevent the same ad from being served to the same user multiple times. For testing purposes, we can override that feature with the cachebuster macro. The creative size should match the sizes we've set in the ad unit and the line item already. Then, we define the creative object with all of the fields we've discussed up to this point. Let's run this example to see the result. Looking at the new creative, we see the size is set properly. We can also see the vast XML URL, the vast redirect type, and the duration all have the values we expect. The final step is to make a LICA, or line item creative association, to connect our video line item and our vast creative. All we have to do is specify the line item ID and the creative ID from our earlier examples. Let's run this example to finish our setup. With that LICA created successfully, and considering the video line item was set to start serving immediately, we're done setting up our ad unit to show a video ad. Here's a quick reminder of the entire setup we have, from the video ad unit to the video line item to the vast redirect creative. Lastly, we're going to take a look at some video-specific reporting metrics to help you see how your video ads are doing. There are three categories of video metrics: video viewership metrics, video interaction metrics, and vast error metrics. Each category has a unique prefix, which is useful for finding them. On the Ad Manager Developer Documentation page for report columns, you can filter by one of these prefixes to see all of the metrics in one of the three categories, as shown here. Let's take a look at each of these metric categories a little more in depth. First, there's video viewership metrics, which tell you how much of the video ad played. These five metrics represent how many times the video started and how many times it played to the 25%, 50%, 75%, and 100% points. There are also some more advanced metrics in this category, like the average view rate, the average view time, the completion rate, and the total error rate. You can see the formula for each of these metrics here. The second category is video interaction metrics. These metrics represent some kind of user action taken on the ad, like collapsing or full screening the ad, muting or unmuting the ad, or playback actions like pause, resume, rewind, or skipping the ad. There's also a metric for the average interaction rate, which is the proportion of times the ad was interacted with in any way, and another metric for the expand rate, which is the proportion of times the ad was expanded. The third and final category is vast error metrics. There are two main types of vast errors: fatal errors that likely stopped the ad request, and then potentially non-fatal errors that may have continued to play the ad. If we look at the Help Center article on VAST and IMA SDK errors, there's a great explanation and resolution for each error. You can see the two types of VAST errors being represented by the two different icons here. Let's take a look at the first error, a VAST XML parsing error. This error usually occurs when the XML that the VAST URL points to is invalid. In the Recommended Action section, you can see that it's up to the buyer to check and update the faulty XML. When we go back to the Ad Manager API documentation for report columns and search for video errors VAST error, we see the corresponding columns for those VAST errors. Each of these columns represents a count of the specific error for the report breakdown. That covers the basics of managing video ads with the Ad Manager API. If your Ad Manager network supports more advanced video functionality, then there are even more ways you can use the Ad Manager API to manage your video ads. Using the Ad Rule service, you can define many more aspects of how your video ads will play, such as targeting pre-roll, mid-roll, and/or post-roll slots. Using the CMS metadata service, you can fetch, activate, or deactivate key value pairs that were ingested from your content management system, or CMS. Finally, the Ad Manager API also offers some functionality for configuring how dynamic ad insertion is handled on your network. If you're interested in using any of these advanced features, first check that your network has access to the feature, and then check out the Help Center articles linked in this video's description to learn more. Thanks for watching, and as always, if you have any questions about the Ad Manager API, reach out to us on the developer forum linked in this video's description.